Let's begin with Andrew Fifita. Now, I understand he remains in hospital after surgery on his larynx, injured during the Sharks' loss to Newcastle. That story did escalate, didn't it? He was in an induced coma, obviously, to help with the breathing that had been constricted so badly.
Tony, as you touched on, he kept playing.
Yeah.
He kept playing. So the teammates and officials were concerned after the game that he was in a bit of a panic state. If they didn't react at that moment, this could have been as catastrophic as it gets. So then obviously they knew by then this was a serious situation and he was due to have surgery today. So in a stable condition now, whether he plays again is debatable. He had 1 year left on his contract. He was almost medically retired last year for a knee injury. So kind of a sad irony that he picked up something else like this, but yeah, freak injury.
Yeah,
freak
absolutely.
Injury.
Wish him all the best. All right, Manly's search toward the top four continues with Tom Trbojevic cleared of serious injury during the ceremonial pantsing of traditional rivals Parramatta. Tommy says he's good to go this weekend, Brent.
Well, he's been named.
Yeah.
Now the reports were after this game the following day that Tommy had a plate inserted some years back and banged his head, banged his cheekbone and disrupted the plate, and they said that he'd be out with a hairline fracture, but he's been named to play. So Tommy might be back.
From Des, well, look, messing with us?
Well, they play the Raiders, the Cowboys and the Bulldogs.
Yep.
The Raiders being the toughest of those three games, I wouldn't be surprised to see Tommy run out.
They're extraordinary at the moment with him. They're playing some great footy.
I think, look, the percentage, win percentage with Tom there to compared to when Tom's not there is enormous. But I think Manly are in a pretty good position to get through. If Tom had to sit out two or three games, I don't think it would worry Manly.
Well, that's three games where he can't hurt his hamstring.
That is a good point. Yeah. So I think they're playing well enough to even do without Tom for the next few weeks, right, if they had to.
All right, it's been the big story, hasn't it? Protect the head of the player. It's been the mantra from the NRL this season, a message largely being ignored, it seems, with another weekend of head thumping. Just go through a couple here. This one, Ryan Madison, definitely not protecting the head of Brad Parker there. That wasn't a good look.
And you knew as soon as this happened, it was going to be a send-off. You can see what players are trying to do. They're trying to change momentum of the game with a shot to jolt the ball free, but when they get it wrong like that, no question he had to go. And 3 weeks, some would say that mightn't have been long enough because it was pretty dangerous. That was called a careless high tackle. Another one, which you might be about to show, was considered reckless. So it's funny how the judiciary, the match review, grade these things.
Yeah. I think even Corey Hutterwood and Ida was in Newey's tackle on Jerome Hughes was ugly. He would have sent himself off if he'd had a whistle.
There did seem to be a little bit more intent with that one. And as Dan said, he came out of the line because at that stage, Canberra were a chance of getting Melbourne Storm. He tried to change things and get things in the favour of the Canberra Raiders. No argument, be sent off. And I think it was a 7-year incident-free clause that saw him get 3 weeks instead of 5 weeks.
He apologised on social media. He was straight on.
Did you feel really bad about it? Brandy, to you, though, it seemed magic round came around and they really seemed to crack down on this head high and all the rulings on that. And we seem to have, I guess, less incidences. Does it just seem like we've had two big ones in the most recent round? So it seems like, I don't want to say it's flared up again.
No,
because it had to be adjusting to the rules as well.
I think because we had two players sent off, which hasn't happened since Magic Round.
Right.
So I think we've had some scattered throughout since Magic Round, Tara, but just two really big ones to everyone go, wow.
Again, put it in the spotlight.
Yeah, I think over those sort of 8 weeks or it's 12 weeks now since Magic Round, there's been a watering down of the incidents, the ones that are accidental with not much force. Magic Round, they were off.
Sinbin.
Yes.
Where that's been watered down.
Yes.
But we've seen a number of high shots where players have been suspended. They were just two send-offs.
Yeah. Mm. Trent Barrett wasn't happy that a try was taken from his team after that Gotoa tackle was penalised. Head of football, Graeme Annesley, wasn't impressed with the latest referee blaming either. Here's Barrett first.
Not late, not high, but on report. And a try taken away from us at a crucial point in the game. And I just don't understand.
I have to say that some of the level of criticism that's been coming about match officials after games, I think is over the top. And I think it's unjustified. We're not hearing anything about the 20 handling errors on average per game. We're not hearing anything about the 60 missed tackles on average per game. We're not hearing anything about the 30 ineffective tackles on average per game, or the 10 line breaks on average per game that teams are conceding.
That's a fair old slapback, isn't it?
He's right, though.
Yeah.
Trent Barrett, his team has won 2 games all year. They're 3 games behind the Broncos, who aren't a good team. He shouldn't be allowed to talk.